Yeah, I mean, I think anytime you get a chance to come back, you know, where you grew up, you know, where your roots are, it's always a special time. You know, we've got a couple guys on our team, Jonathan Mitchell and Dan Warner, you know, from the metropolitan area.
Sure.
We probably have some guys on our team that have never been to New York before and have heard about Madison Square Garden. And, you know, certainly I think this is a special environment when you look at the tradition of the NIT and what the NIT meant, you know, back in the 60s, the 50s, and then obviously the way they have taken the NIT and have made a preseason tournament out of it that's gotten a lot of exposure and publicity. So I think the NIT has been something that's really been a mainstay and been a positive contributor to college basketball. And, you know, for us to come back into this environment in New York to play, I think for our team is special.
Does it make it obviously a big stage, but you know, not the stage that you were on last year in terms of that transition and, you know, working back. What's it like to, you know, play in this Final Four as compared to last year?
Well, you know, I think for our team it's a different path you gotta go through, in a way. You know, I'm not surprised with what we lost of where we're at. I think that when you talk about having half your team being freshmen, there's a multitude of things you look at as a coach before the season starts to say, you know what, here are some things that could be potential problems for our team. There's some things that these guys have done that have really exceeded my expectations, and there's been some things that we need to continue to grow at and get better at. But this is a chance for us to play on a neutral site against a quality team in UMass and to try to get better and improve and continue to develop as a team. And you're hopeful that these experiences actually carry over into the following year, because again, we have no seniors and everybody is returning, and we're adding a lot of new players next year. So next year we're a little bit deeper, but I'm hopeful that these experiences right now going this far into the season provide an opportunity for our guys to step up and provide leadership. I think if there's one thing that's been lacking on our team, and it's not their fault, it's hard to expect a group of freshmen to lead. But hopefully through this experience they can lead. And you know what, I think a lot of people talk about the freshman wall, and we've talked about that in February. But one thing I like too about what's happened is the length of our season with such a young group is terrific, that we're playing so long. And a lot of people don't realize this around, at least in Florida, we started our first day of classes. When this tournament ends, there'll be 2.5 weeks left to school, and these guys are done. So you're talking about these guys have gone for a long, long time playing. And when you got a young group, you know, generally they can just hit the wall and just run out of gas and steam. I think that these guys have continued to try to get better and improve and develop as a team, as individuals.